replacing nutrition or replacing good nutrition where poor nutrition had distorted the function of the body. Okay. And I became very, very, very interested in techniques like energy medicine. Every cell in the body has a potential, an electrical potential called a zeta potential across its cell membrane. If that zeta potential is low, you will get cancer. You will become vulnerable to autoimmune.
So those are the level of the energy of the cell.
Precisely. So I became very interested in energy medicine, in what I call my toys, the gadgets and gizmos that the FDA of the United States bans as quickly as they can. The FDA, by the way, is the most single corrupt organization on the planet, as far as I'm aware, and I call it the Fraud and Death Administration.
Fraud and Death Administration.
Correct. Correcto. How do you say that in Spanish?
La administración fraud and la administración de la muerte y el fraude.
Perfecto.
Administración de la muerte y el fraude.
It is controlled start to finish by the industrial agriculture industry and by the pharmaceutical industry. Now, the pharmaceutical industry and the industrial agriculture industry are the same industry because the people who make the chemicals are the people who make the drugs that you have to take when you get sick.
The same company.
Food with the chemistry.
The same companies.
That, for instance, Monsanto is a drug company. It is a chemical company. It makes Agent Orange. It made Agent Orange during the Vietnam War. Today's glyphosato Roundup, which Monsanto genetically modifies its crops to be able to withstand because it's so poisonous, so you'll use more and more and more and more of it. Glyphosato no longer kills the pests and the herbs and the bugs, the things that it was designed to get rid of. Although it's an herbicide, it kills lots of things. So they've added Agent Orange, 70% Agent Orange to a container of glyphosato.
So they create the problem and they create the cure. That's a great business.
They don't create a cure, Miguel. What they create is a make-believe cure. It's called a lie. In fact, the pharmaceutical industry makes no money if you're cured. If you have...
You have to be dependent.
You have to be dependent. And better yet, once you take a drug, then you get side effects. And so instead of saying, I guess that was a bad choice, the doctor says, oops, change better add another drug. Change your medicine and add another drug to deal with the side effects. And now you have two drugs interacting in ways that are not known. And so you have more side effects, so we add another drug. Now you're on three, and then you're up to 11, and then you're up to God knows how many, and then you die. And that is part of the plan, because there is a genocidal agenda articulated clearly. Genocide, I believe, is the word in Spanish. The plan has been articulated clearly by the World Health Organization, by the United States, by the United Nations, in search of something misnamed a sustainable planet. These organizations have said we must reduce the population to 10% of its current level. The Nazis tried this, and they had a policy of eliminating what they called useless eaters. If you would like, you can go to our website, globalhealthfreedom.org. globalhealthfreedom.org, and if you read English, you can look up an article called The Killing Fields of Codex, or you can watch a video called Nutricide. Now, these document in detail the Nazi roots of the pharmaceutical industry, which is the same pharmaceutical industry that we're dealing with today, which is the same agribiz chemical industry that is degrading our food on a global basis to create business and to get rid of us. Now that sounds crazy, doesn't it?
Sounds a little bit.
It is crazy. The problem.
Poco loco.
Poco loco, mucho loco, I would say. The problem is it's real, and it's in black and white. I have documentation, which I have published on that website. And by the way, anybody can sign up for the Health Freedom Action e-alerts. They're free, they're secure. It's a newsletter. And you need that information. Is it pleasant? Is it fun? Does it give you giggles? No indeedy. But do you need it so that you and your family and your culture can survive? Oh yes. Because here's a secret. Would you like to know a secret?
Sure.
Lean closer. Okay, here's the secret. This is the secret that the globalists do not want you to know. And that is that you are powerful. You are not isolated. You are not unable to make change. If you combine with other people and you raise your voices and you create the demand, what happens is that every single time, without exception, the globalists step back. Now they come
What about all these people that they say, oh, Dr. Rima, the conspiracy theory, and you know, maybe they're watching you and they think, oh, you know, it's all the theory, but in reality it doesn't happen like that. I mean, do you have specifics really in the website that you can tell and you can really find out?
You know, Miguel, extraordinary claims require extraordinary documentation. I'm making extraordinary claims. I'm claiming that there are people who want to kill you, who want to make sure that you'll never have a child, who want to make sure that the population will wither and die to 10% of its current level. That's extraordinary. In order to protect anyone's assessment of my sanity, but more importantly, in order to effect change, that had better be well documented, and it is. The World Health Organization said in documents which I have published on my website in 1985 that the real reason, and this is something that they wrote themselves in black and white, the real reason for the smallpox eradication and vaccination program was not the eradication of smallpox. That was all propaganda. The real reason was, and I quote, to eliminate 150 million excess sub-Saharan Africans, end quote. Well, what is an excess sub-Saharan African? Could it be a person who is consuming resources that the globalists want for themselves? Indeed. I treated a head of state, was not the Queen of England. I treated a head of state in my medical practice in Westchester County, New York, in about 2002 and 2003. And she was a very friendly, chatty lady. And she said one day, you know, it's almost time for the great culling, C-U-L-L-I-N-G, the great culling to begin. I said, what? What are you talking about? And I thought maybe she had an appointment and she was going to a play called Great Culling. I had no idea what she was talking about. And she looked at me as if I were completely idiotic. And she said, the Great Culling, eliminating the useless eaters. I said, what are useless eaters? She said, those people who are consuming our non-renewable natural resources. And I said to her, because I speak my mind no matter where I am and no matter to whom I am speaking, I told the president...
That's why you invited here.
Exactly. I told the president of India in a private meeting that he was absolutely wrong, and because of that, 6 weeks later, India changed her food policy. So I speak my mind, and whatever happens, happens. I said to her, what are you talking about, useless eaters? Did it ever occur to you that you are consuming their natural resources? And she looked off in the distance the way people do when they're considering a new idea, and she said, that's an interesting way of looking at it. I never thought about it like that. I said, well, does it change anything for you? She said, no. And I said, well, who are these useless eaters? She said, everyone except us, the people who keep us comfortable, and the technicians who support what we need. I said, well, where does this come from? She said, oh, we've been working on this for